To use Microsoft 365 backup for OneDrive, SharePoint, or Exchange, you need to create a backup policy for each workload. A policy defines the protection units, such as the SharePoint sites or users that are backed up in each workload. Protection units is how we'll refer to those protected sites and users moving forward. OneDrive and EXO setup are very similar since they are focused around the user. We'll use OneDrive as the example here, but keep in mind that archive mailboxes are included when enrolling an EXO user or shared mailbox. Let's create a backup policy for OneDrive. The policy defines which OneDrive accounts are backed up. The backup frequency is not modifiable and does not impact the cost of the solution. Variable retention will be introduced in a later version of the product offering. A protection scope is the scope of user accounts within OneDrive that you want to protect with Microsoft 365 backup. You can upload a list of accounts to backup via a CSV file, backup accounts that match specific filters, and you can backup accounts by selecting them individually. You can choose to set up OneDrive user accounts using any or all three ways. For now, let's choose to select the accounts individually. You can select a single account or multiple accounts to add a backup policy. Once we've selected the accounts and reviewed the policy information, we can create the backup policy for OneDrive. We've successfully created our OneDrive backup policy. After creating a backup policy, the scope can be edited as needed. Let's edit the OneDrive backup policy and remove an account. Removing an account from Microsoft 365 backup doesn't mean existing backups will be deleted. Rather, it means additional backups won't be taken. To remove an account from the existing backup policy, select the account from the list and then select Remove. Removed protection units are excluded from the policy, but retain their previous backup in the Remove tab. And just like that, our OneDrive backup policy is updated.